Hanuman was on the lookout for Sita, but what he saw was a spectacle of the glory of Ravana, the king of Lanka. He first saw Ravana, who was fast asleep, a handsome man dressed in fabulous jewels and splendid clothes. He was beloved of the virgins and a source of joy to the Rakshasas. Red sandal paste on his limbs made him look like the sun at dusk. Wearing glowing rings, with large red eyes, long arms, golden robes, and resting after a night of debauchery and liquor, Ravana looked splendid. Valmiki spares no details of the sumptuous living of Ravana. It's a pleasure to read today after 7,000 years of the happening. Hanuman naturally was frightened at the sight of the king. He found Ravana's arms were powerful and well built. His fingernails and thumbs bore auspicious marks. Spread eagled over the spotless bed, his palms looked like two cobras with five hoods each. Hanuman imagined how in the battlefield these arms would have reduced the Yakshas, Nagas, Gandharvas, Devatas and Asuras to tears. The king's lotus face, writes Valmiki, glistening in the light of his gold earrings, glowed all the more in the unusual reflection of light from his golden crown, studded with pearls that lay beside his head. Below the waist, his body was covered by a loose white silk sheet. His torso, however, was wrapped in expensive yellow silks. Lying on the luminous white bed, Ravana looked like a mighty elephant resting in the limitless waters of the Ganges. Hanuman soon noticed some of the mighty king's favorite wives sleeping at the foot of his bed. His mistresses, beautiful women with narrow waists, intoxicated with liquor and exhausted with making love, lay asleep in a disheveled state wherever they could. The finest of danseuses, the one who had been specially crafted by the Creator, the one who could move her limbs with delicacy and dance with exquisite grace, although fast asleep, looked as if she was still expressing Shringar Bhav. What an image! Another lay clasping her veena to her chest. She looked like a water lily stuck to a boat in the river Mahanadi. Still another, with kaul in her eyes, was fast asleep, with a small musical instrument by her side. A delicate accompanist with attractive breasts lay asleep on her tabor like a woman pressing her long lost lover to her body. A lotus-eyed young woman clung to her veena like a woman lying asleep in a passionate embrace with her lover. What a visual and what an imagination! However, apart from these women in plenty, Hanuman saw a stunningly charming woman lying in a separate bed. She had put on pearls and jewels. She enhanced the loveliness of the palace. She was fair of complexion, had a golden glow. She was Ravana's beloved, mistress of the harem named Mandodari. Leaving aside Ravana, who slept like a bull surrounded by cows in a cowshed, Kapishrestha Hanuman walked into the kitchens and the dining halls of the palace. In the pleasure hall, which had been lavishly decorated with flowers, Hanuman found women sleeping intertwined. Intoxicated, some of them had undressed the others before clasping them in a close embrace. Hanuman savored the fragrance of cool sandalwood, liquors, wines, honey, sundry flowers, toiletries, and incense wafting on a mild breeze. Notice the advanced civilization which we are talking about. Seven thousand years ago, Lanka had made tremendous progress. It continues to be a beautiful country with beautiful women and handsome men even today. Hanuman felt guilty about peering at the women lying asleep. He thought that this was the end of his dharma and virtue. He had not only looked at women belonging to others, but also he had seen Ravana, the evil incarnate, the one who had abducted another's woman from close quarters. However, applying logic, Hanuman argued thus: no doubt Ravana's women were sleeping innocently, completely unaware of their surroundings, and I have seen them in this condition. Yet my mind never went astray with lust. It is the mind that steers our senses towards good or evil, the desirable or the undesirable. Fortunately, thought Hanuman, my mind did not deviate from the path of propriety. Hanuman's search continues till he arrives at Ashok Vatika, where Sita was imprisoned. He was sure that Sita would never have surrendered to Ravana, therefore she could not have been kept captive in an open space like the harem. He also thought, might be, Sita is no more. But he knew that if he tells this guess his office, Ravan would be happy and Rama would not survive. The story continues more and more beautiful. You can enjoy all of it in my translation of Valmiki Ramayana, published by Rupa Publishers Private Limited. I thank you for sparing your time to listen to this discourse. Valmiki Ramayana is a book full of history, real happenings, philosophy, ethics, politics, and more than anything else, Karuna Ras in the shape of Sita's suffering almost all through her life. Thank you very much for patience which you have bestowed upon my reading from the text. Bye-bye.